During the State of the Nation address at Kololo Independence Grounds, President Yoweri Museveni highlighted the strides made by government in steering the economy, security and welfare of the country to a better position, basing on the fundamental principles laid out by the National Resistance Movement. The president, however, raised concern about soaring cases of corruption in the country across all sectors, saying efforts are underway to deal with the vice. Museveni quoted instances where a racket of officials from the Minister of Finance and Parliament connived to steal public funds. Museveni said that he was further shocked to note that some people take bribes in State House to enable guests see him.
I've been getting good information about corrupt actors among the public servants, but also among the political actors. With firm evidence, we shall crush these traitors.
Museveni also gave assurance that Uganda cannot be intimidated by foreigners who work with intent to malice the country, warning that those in the country working for foreigners and their interests are criminals and traitors and shall be punished.
Here, I have banned the export of unprocessed minerals. If a mineral is not fully processed, I don't allow it to be exported.
President Museveni also emphasized the need to bring to realization the East African integration dream in order for member states to attain what he termed as insurance of the people of East Africa.
There are, however, still non-tariff barriers. With His Excellency William Ruto recently, we agreed to remove all these barriers against sugar, milk, eggs, fruit juices, etc.
He, however, cited the strides so far made by the NRM government in fostering cross-border trade, removal of non-tariff barriers, witnessed through the signing of various bilateral agreements among the East African states. The president, however, urged Ugandans to pursue the realization of pending tasks which include indulgence in wealth creation programs such as PDM, education for all, and a push for the realization of East African Federation. The Minister for Kampala Capital City and Metropolitan Affairs, Hajet Misa Kabanda, has assured the public that the payment salary arrears for the KCSA casual labourers who have been striking since Tuesday this week will be secured. According to the minister, they have secured a tune of 13.69 billion shillings for paying all the arrears for the cleaners starting tomorrow.
But what the billion kuminasatu? Mwemilion ni nkaga mwenda. Futansi okuloadinga sente zo ku mitimbagano okulaba nga zigenda ku accounts z'abantu 13 mu mtaja kubanga afunye sente ze.
Speaking to the press, Kabanda said the authority will recruit the laborers afresh after paying all their arrears. She urged all of them to come with their relevant identification documents when the process begins. The agitated casual workers, however, could not allow the deputy director KCCA, Engineer Luimbazi, to address them in this meeting. The United States on Wednesday warned against an escalation in Lebanon after Israel Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu warned of an operation, saying conflict would only harm Israel's security. State Department spokesman Matthew Miller told reporters that United States does not want to see that escalation of the conflict, which would just lead to further loss of life from both Israel's and the Lebanese people. Netanyahu visited the northern border area after 8 months of war with Hamas that has devastated Gaza and warned Israel was prepared for a very intense operation along the border.
تباحتنا الوضع الاقتصادي والوضع المجتمعي بالإضافة إلى الحالة الأمنية الموجودة في غزة وفي الضفة الغربية وأيضا في.
The trip comes after nearly daily fire with firefighters in Lebanon from Hezbollah, like Hamas, and an ally of Iran's clerical state. Miller, however, played down suggestions that war was imminent with Lebanon. Miller said the U.S. understood the untenable situation for Israel on its northern border.